Yeah. I'm gonna go over and put a chain up in the tree between two trees. That way I can lift those logs into place later. So that's the first thing to do is, oh, I gotta get a ladder out. Okay, here we go again. But I gotta get a ladder, I'm gonna go up and get this chain affixed. That's my first project of the day. Straps are rated at 2,000 pounds apiece, so I'm going to wrap them around the trunk of that tree to protect it, because all the pulling, I don't want to, this tree's a keeper, so I don't want to damage the bark. This one's rated at 3,800 pounds. These are picked up at a basket of these at the auction pretty cheap. They're made in Rockford, Illinois, Caldwell. I think they're some pretty, probably pretty pricey straps. Thank you. working so far. Now with the chain stretched across there, I can just put a step ladder here and I'll hook the electric winch onto the cable of the chain right here where we can pick a log up and put it right on our cabin base. And then if I want to raise the chain up higher, I've got this chain binder that I can hook between the two chains that are hooked together, and I can pull them together, and I can, anyway, I can take the slack out of that chain and it'll raise it up more feet as I need it. So I think for quite a while this operation is going to work okay. I think it's time for some breakfast. I think I paid about $100 or less for this Master Lock electric winch. It's 12 volt. It'll pull 2,000 pounds. Now I'll tell you what, for less than $100, it's about the best cabin partner a guy could have when you don't have anybody else stops in that you can put to work. This one's always out there ready to lend a helping hand. Doesn't require pie or anything, so it has really worked out well. I'm going to put it to work again here now. It's just the official cabin raising. I think we're going to say that we're going to, the week of September 30th, 2024, that's when we're going to really put these walls up, have the guys coming in if it works out for everybody. But before I leave this trip, though, I want to get one more, the log on each end, so we got the whole base in, and get that notched in, get it all solid. Then I can get some more stone piers underneath. So we're going to go over and we're going to pick out a few of the biggest logs for this first tier down here and get started. I have a lot of really nice logs to choose from. I think I'm going to start off with number 3 here and number 6. They have a diameter halfway down of about 9 inches, and they hold that diameter all the way to the small tip. So I think that as we go along, we'll just try to use the biggest ones and then taper up toward the top. But I think I have enough pretty nice logs that we won't be really tapering all that much. on them off a little bit there. But for the first one, that's not bad. I'll shove that over, set it on there, and we're in good shape. When I set this up, I was thinking more about balancing the weight than I was the distance. So it's going to work out good because I can push this around enough to get the job done. I think that calls for a little more coffee and maybe a half of that pie. This is working out great. Imagine what it'd be like when I got all that help here. Always a good idea to take that coffee break and then sit back and see what you did. When I did, I realized that I've got this log on here wrong. Be fine if this was going here, but this log is going on that end, and so the big fat end has to match up the narrow end over there. So just a matter of putting my strap back on. I'll adjust it slightly. We'll see how our balance is. Got plenty of room to swing it around, so it's no big deal, but just one of those things that as I practice here, we're learning. You know, I've been buying stuff for this project for years, and all these straps, some are a little worn, so we'll be careful with them, but that strap is rated for, I don't know, 5,000 pounds or something like that, so I have a couple of them. Anyway, I've been accumulating all these things for years, so it's kind of nice to see that they're working. Probably some stuff I won't be using, but, you know, these step ladders I've been hauling out, and every little thing has been getting ready for this project, so that's why it's nice to kind of play around and put a few logs up so I kind of know what to expect and maybe something I'm missing. So I think we can spin this around now. Got enough room. I did notice I'm going to have to get my chain tightened up a little more. If I got any higher, I kind of maxed out right there. Just don't ever get under anything. Prop something against that end and get it pushed over and drop it. I haven't broke a swell all morning, no sense of starting now. Now I just need to carefully roll this. Make sure I don't fall off one end to the other. Really nice to know it's going to work. Laying in bed at night thinking about trying to move these big ones around, even with help, had me wondering. But I can see now with the proper hoist and tools, we can do it safely. Things are sure easier the second time around. I took a tape measure and I measured where to put my strap, so took care of those problems, and I know this big end, I have to swing it around and put it over there. So I made a mistake one time, but I'm sure I have to do it again. Just slow down and think. Well, she wrote there. Now, I think, yeah, just don't get my feet under it. And it's not even anywhere near lunchtime.